Judas Priest lead singer Rob Halford reads his rejection letter from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame live on the air. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music. The letter was from Greg Harris, who is the CEO and the president of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and it was an innocent letter, like your basic form letter, explaining why you didn't get in. But some fans, some Judas Priest fans, are not happy with sort of the ending. Well, they're not happy at all because they didn't get inducted, but you understand. One fan online called the letter, "You stink, but we'll let you through the doors." Seems a little harsh. Halford was at a Phoenix radio station, 100.7 KSLX, talking about the inductees, Bon Jovi, Nina Simone, the Cars, the Moody Blues, Dire Straits, and Sister Rosetta Tharpe. And the folks who were rejected, of course, Judas Priest, Radiohead, Kate Bush, Rage Against the Machine, Depeche Mode, Eurythmics, MC5, and LL Cool J. Halford said he would have loved to be inducted, adding, "We've put in our 10,000 hours for sure. Beyond that, we just feel that heavy metal music deserves more space on the shelves of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame." Now here's the letter he received from Harris. "Thank you for embracing your nomination for induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. While you didn't garner enough votes for induction this year, you were part of a very select group of Hall of Fame nominees. Artists are frequently on the ballot multiple times. For example, Black Sabbath were nominated 8 times before induction." Here's what he said at the end. "If you are touring or simply traveling nearby, please visit our museum in Cleveland, Ohio. Our 6 floors of exhibitions tell the remarkable history of rock and roll and how it changed the world. You're part of that story," which was nice that he included that, "and we'd love to share it with you. Again, congratulations on your nomination." Now, I know some folks are going crazy about that last part, the fact that he was selling a little bit, but it was just an innocent statement of going, "Hey, if you're in town, please come by." Are people overreacting to this? I think a little bit. When I was running radio stations, I'd have to write letters like that, and sometimes it's hard to figure tone. I mean, especially in this day of the digital age, it's hard to figure tone in emails and texts sometimes and stuff. It was a harmless letter. Do they belong there? Of course they belong. They're a monstrous band. And even Halford said he knows they will get in eventually. But again, what do you think? Make sure you comment on our videos, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. We'd appreciate that. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music.